Well, it's official. Apple just released iOS 18.1 with the first Apple Intelligence features. Want to know how to use them? Stay tuned. I'm Dylan Stewart, the Mac Whisperer, and in today's video, we're going to dive deep into the brand new iOS 18.1 update that includes our first look at Apple Intelligence. Stay tuned for my MacWhisperer power tip where I show you how to use Apple Intelligence in the Photos app. Let's hop on over to the phone and get started. For the last several months, Apple has been hyping Apple Intelligence, which is their new AI features that are built directly into your phone. And there's a lot of amazing features. They aren't being released all at once, but with iOS 18.1, we see the first batch of them, and there's some really cool things to get into here. I've broken the new features into several different categories. So let's start off with category number one, summarization. Have you ever gotten a long email or a long text message or even been trying to read a really long web page and wish that someone would just give you the highlights? Well, Apple Intelligence will do that now with the summarization features that are built into Mail, Text Message, and Safari. Let's hop on over to Text Message to take a look. When you first come into your text message app, you're going to notice this little icon right here. This icon means that the text that's been sent has been summarized. This can be really helpful when someone sends a long text or multiple texts at the exact same time. You'll see the summary right here, but clicking on the message will reveal the full information, even if it's a really long text. It's a great way to get a bird's eye view of what a message is without even having to click on it. Here you can see that Reginald texted me asking about unfinished projects and lunch plans on Wednesday. If I click into the message itself, you're going to see it's actually two completely separate texts, one talking about projects and one talking about lunch. But Apple Intelligence has summarized both of them for me so that I don't actually have to read the full text to get the gist of what Reginald's asking. It works in Mail as well. If you come into your Mail app here, you're going to notice summarization showing up right in your inbox. Here, I get the information that there's a paid collaboration offer. Or down here, Venmo shows me that somebody was trying to log into my account. These summaries can make it easy to get the gist of an email without even having to open it up. And it also works inside of Safari. When you find yourself on a Safari website with a ton of information and you don't really have the time to read it all, you can click down on this little icon on your address bar here and choose to show the reader. The reader is a distraction-free environment allowing you to see the entire message without all of the advertisements and photos and other clutter. But with Apple Intelligence, when you click Show Reader, you'll also get the opportunity to summarize the website simply by clicking here. It'll give you a paragraph or two about exactly what's going on in that website, so you don't actually have to read the whole thing. Pretty awesome. The next category of features is writing tools, and this can allow you to bring artificial intelligence, proofreading, and rewriting tools directly into anything that you write. Here I've got an article that I've been writing about one of my clients, but maybe I need it to be a little bit more professional. Simply select whatever part of the text you want to change, and then you can either use this Apple Intelligence button on the formatting toolbar or on the pop-up menu, you can click the arrow to find your writing tools. Let's click on it. The writing tools have several different options, including the ability for you to proofread your text, to rewrite it in case you want to rephrase what you've written, or to make it more friendly, professional, or concise. It's also got the ability to summarize your text, create key points, or even create a list or a table right from this text. Let's go ahead and make this more professional. I'm going to click this button here. It's going to read that text and then give me a suggestion of how to make it feel a little bit more businesslike. If you like it, you can keep it and click the Done button. If you don't like it, you can press Rewrite to have it give it another shot, or you can revert back to the original. You can also come in and change the tone to make it more friendly or more concise. Let's try the friendly option. It rewrites the message and makes it just a little bit more personal. Again, if you like it, you can click Done or offer it to rewrite it or jump back to your original. Let's click Done here. But what if you need to proofread the text that you've written? Easy enough to do that by activating Apple Intelligence. I'm going to do it from the toolbar right here. Clicking on the proofread button will read the text and make any changes for grammar or spelling that it recommends. You'll see right here, it's underlined in purple all the changes it's made. If I want to keep them, just click Done and continue on with what you're doing. You can even use it to create a summary of a long piece of text. In this case, let's go ahead and select all. Let's go to our Apple Intelligence features on the formatting bar here, and let's scroll down to where it says key points. Clicking this will immediately read all of that information, and it will give you all of the key points of that message very clearly laid out. You can either replace your existing text, share it, or copy that summary to use it elsewhere. But it's not just available in Notes, it's available anywhere you type. For example, if I come into Messages here and go to type up a message to someone, I can have it rephrase it. So it's my friend's birthday, and I just toss some words down, but I'd like it to be a little more friendly. Let's select everything we've got here, click on our Apple Intelligence feature there, and choose the friendly option. And it rewrites my message, making it even more personal and making sure that my friend knows how much I'm thinking about him on his birthday. And one of the other nice features of Apple Intelligence is that when you come into a text message or an email chain and there's some questions being asked, you'll get suggestions that are much more accurate than they used to be. You'll see down here, I can immediately tell Reginald that I'd like sushi or that I'd like Thai food. He clearly asked me which one I'd prefer, so now I can just click one button right here, send it out, and be ready for a sushi lunch with my friend Reginald. And Apple Intelligence also provides a great feature inside of Mail. Let's go ahead and click on the Mail icon here, and up at the top of my messages, you're gonna notice this new Priority section. The Priority section looks through your inbox and grabs messages that are important or that you haven't responded to and brings them front and center right here. If you're not interested in having Apple provide the priority messages for you, you can click on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner to turn it off, but it makes it so simple for you to stay on top of your messages without dropping anything out. The next section for Apple Intelligence is some of the updates they've made to some of our favorite apps. For example, you can now record a phone call directly from the phone app. Let me show you what I mean. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the phone app here, and I'm gonna call my friend Frank. As soon as Frank picks up the call, you'll notice this icon in the upper left-hand corner. This will allow you to easily record a phone call and even get a transcript from that call. Simply pressing this button will alert the other parties that you're going to be recording this call, and then it will transcribe and record everything that happens on this call. This makes it so easy to make sure you've got all of the information from any phone call that you have, especially if it's a business meeting or something that you need to take notes on. You don't need to take notes anymore because Apple will take them for you right through this recording. When you're done, press the stop button right here. And when you'd like to find the recording, hop over into your Notes app, go to the folder section here, and up at the top, you will see a section for call recordings. Clicking onto it here will give you a basic summary and allow you to play back that message, and then it will immediately transcribe and record. Or if you click on the recording inside of your note, you'll get all of the transcript right here. And by pressing the three dots in the upper right-hand corner, you can add the transcript to this note, copy the transcript, find specific things in the transcript, or even save or share the audio from that recording. There's also some fantastic tools built right into Safari. Have you ever been on one of those web pages where these distracting messages pop up right in your face, like this one that's prompting me to use the Google app? I'm in Safari, I don't want to use the Google app, and I don't want you bugging me about that every time I come to this page. Well, now with Apple Intelligence, you can easily remove distracting items. You do it by clicking on the icon in the lower left corner of your address bar here, and you'll see this option for hiding distracting items. Once you enable it, you can press on any distracting images on a website, just like this one here, click hide, and it will disappear, never bugging you on that website ever again. It's a great feature that can allow you to customize your web pages so those things that are always popping up and making you crazy are gone forever. We'll do it again here. Click on this icon here, click hide distracting items, press on the item you'd like to hide, and confirm it. Click the Done button down here, and it won't bug you anymore. Apple Intelligence has a ton of great features. Those are some of the best ones from iOS 18.1, but in the coming months, we'll see even more tools, including the ability to create your own images, create your own emojis, and even more. iOS 18.1 is a great update, and I'm so excited that we finally get to see some of these Apple Intelligence features. But that's not all of the features that iOS 18.1 has. In a moment, I'm going to reveal my MacWhisperer power tip, where I show you how Apple Intelligence is changing the Photos app. It's exciting stuff. But if you've already learned something new today and got great value from this video, give it a thumbs up to make it easier for other people to find it. And if you've got a question or a comment, something you want to know more about, drop it down into the comments section. I absolutely love to help you guys make the most out of your Apple products. And now, let's get into that power tip. I know. Nobody likes the new Photos app, but some of these features may change your opinion. Let's jump into the Photos app and I'll show you what I mean. One of the first major Apple Intelligence changes to Photos occurs down in this section called Memories. Memories is a feature that's been in Photos for a while, giving you the ability to see pictures from a particular time, a particular place, particular people. They're automatically created, and sometimes they're great and sometimes they're whatever. But now you can create your own memories using Apple Intelligence. Here's how you do it. Click on the Create button in the upper right-hand corner here, and you'll be prompted with this screen. Here, you can tell Apple exactly what you'd like to see in the memory. Let's try it. Disneyland visits with Jack Johnson music. Simply click the button right here, and it will begin processing through all of your photos to find the Disneyland pictures, and it will even add the music you requested. It only takes a moment. You'll notice down below the different searches that it's doing to find the right pictures, and all of a sudden, here we are with theme park fun over the years. As it moves through the different pictures, you'll hear the music you chose. By tapping on the screen, you can change the music by clicking in the lower left-hand corner here. This can allow you to do different styles with different songs with just a simple click. This one's black and white using the Better Together Jack Johnson song. And this one uses Sitting, Waiting, Wishing with bright images. It's so easy to make and so fun to do it. That's one of my favorite Apple Intelligence features for iOS 18.1 with Photos, but it's not the only one. One of the most powerful Apple Intelligence features that they've released so far is called Cleanup, and it can allow you to go into your photos and remove unwanted items that wrecked an otherwise perfect picture. Let's hop into this picture here, and the picture is great, but the handbag on the shelf is just in the way. Let's click on the Settings button down below in order to edit the picture. And on the bottom right side, we'll see the new Cleanup option. Clicking on that will help you remove any items from this picture, like the handbag. Let's now rub our finger directly over the handbag, just like that. Give it a few moments, and it's gone, just like that. Back in the day, we needed to use third-party apps in order to do that, but because of Apple Intelligence and iOS 18.1, it's now brought directly into the Photos app. So that's what we've got for today's video about iOS 18.1 and Apple Intelligence. Check out this video right here for more information about how to use your Apple products even better. I'm Dylan Stewart. I'll see you next time.